Welcome back. Let's invite the management of IIFL Wealth. They reported a good quarter. There is a sequential improvement in the revenues to the tune of about 7%. The revenues now stand at 283 crore for the quarter. The stock is down 3%, but bear in mind, it's up 50% since the start of the year. Karan Bhagat, the MD and CEO of IIFL Wealth Management, now joins us on the show. Karan, morning. This is Reema here. First, if you could tell us the 7% revenue growth on a quarter-on-quarter basis, is it sustainable?
Good afternoon, Reema. No, I think, Reema, we started out on this journey 2.5 years back to make our revenue substantially more sustainable. And I think we made good progress there. So to answer your question, it's definitely sustainable. We report our sustainable revenues as annual recurring revenue separately and our transaction revenue separately. The biggest growth we've seen on a quarter-on-quarter basis is essentially on the ARR revenue aspect, and which is where we've seen a growth of nearly 8 to 9% quarter-on-quarter. And therefore, yes, is definitely sustainable, and it's a trend which is likely to continue.
Right, Karan. Morning, Prashant here.
Hi, Prashant.
Hi. When you say ARR, it's basically the fees that you collect on the assets, right?
It's a combination of three elements, really, Prashant. Hmm. So it essentially refers to the revenue you would make on stock. So effectively, the fees you would collect on the AUM
right.
without the need to do a transaction.
Right.
And the transaction revenue really is the revenue which comes in only as and when you either change the instrument
right.
or earn a brokerage. So that's the distinction between the two.
Right. No, you said there are three elements into ARR. Which are the other two?
Into ARR. Yeah. So into ARR itself, the first element is really the management fees you charge the client
right.
on the portfolio management services on the wealth management side, the advisory fee you charge clients on the advisory business, and lastly, the management fees we charge on the alternate asset management business. These three elements put together comprise the ARR.
How many new clients did you add, Karan?
So we've added around about 250 odd clients for the quarter, Prashant. So, but bear in mind, we service around about 6,500-7,000 families across the country. So an addition of 250-300 clients for us is a fairly meaningful number for the quarter. This is obviously on the wealth management side. On the alternate asset management side, the numbers would be higher. But that is something which is distributed by our own wealth management business as well as other distributors.
The alternate asset management is basically where you offer your own products and distribute other products for others as well. That's
so really, I think the way the asset management business has emerged in India is two distinct parts now. One is the traditional long only mutual funds, which obviously as an industry has grown rapidly over the last 20 to 25 years. I think since 2016, SEBI gave, in a sense, the birth to the alternative investment fund. And since then to now, it's done a great great job in kind of allowing the industry to grow. I think within the alternate asset space, we've built a fairly large business of 30 to 35,000 crores, largely split into four strategies, the listed equity piece, the unlisted equity piece, structured credit, as well as a few long short strategies. These four put together largely comprise the alternate assets piece. For us, unlisted equity and listed equity are the largest components of these two businesses.
Karan, you said you started off on the journey to make your business more sustainable about 2.5 years ago. As we see your AUM mix right now, it's predominantly wealth. That is about 70 to 80% of the AUM is in the wealth basket. Could you tell us how you see this mix changing? Is there a target size in terms of the book that you would like to achieve? And what are the transaction charges that you gain on these two segments, wealth as well as asset management?
So Reema, I think from an AUM mix, I think it'll continue to be around about 70 to 30 on the wealth management side as opposed to the asset management side. I think the wealth management, both the businesses fortunately for us have large tailwinds for the next 2, 5, 10 years, and both will continue to grow. I think obviously as an opportunity and our ability to go out and source clients there, I think the wealth management business just in terms of AUM might grow faster. The alternate assets business, however, is a fairly young industry, and therefore the percentage growth there may be higher. But in terms of our overall AUM, I think 70 to 30 is more or less, I think, the mix which is kind of going to stay as we go along over the next 5 to 10 years.
And in terms of fees that you enjoy on these two?
So I think transaction fees really is coming down, and it's for clients who are either portfolio management clients with us or they pay us an advisory fee. We charge practically zero on transaction. So effectively, our execution services are practically zero, provided the client is a portfolio management or an advisory client with us. So we're very clear that we want to kind of ensure that the client and us are on the same side of the table as soon as he becomes an advisory client, because all conflicts, transaction charges, and commissions all become zero as soon as the client becomes an advisory client. I think in that sense, you know, the advisory regulations are path-breaking, and it's something which the industry will really benefit, and most importantly, the clients will benefit over the next 3 to 5 years.
Karan, it's a pleasure. Thank you very much for joining us and running us through what you make of the business. Thank you, as always, for joining us. We'll take a very quick break here. We are back.